This video gives step-by-step instructions for how to print articles for patrons. If a patron wants to print an article, there are a few ways you can make their life a little easier. When a patron comes up to the desk asking you to print something for them, you'll open the email page that should be up in your browser. If the email page isn't open, you can click the printer inbox icon at the top of the browser. Once the email's up, ask the patron for their name and find the email from them. Once you open the link to their article, and I've got some open over here, so I'm going to close that, but you'll just click their link. Once you open the link to their article, look for a print icon. That's the first thing I would do. So the best place to look is when you see these social media signs. Usually there's a little share button or a print icon right here. So I'm going to click their share button, and that's where the New York Times has their print icon. So I can go ahead and click print. And it's only 4 pages. They've gotten rid of all the pictures that were taking up space. So that'll only be 40 cents for that patron. If you don't see a print icon, so we'll go ahead and close this and we'll look at this AL.com article. So if you don't see a print icon anywhere, and if I come down here, no print icon. I'll make sure. And that's the whole article, so looks like we don't have a print icon. You can click this little leaf icon up here at the top. This is clean print. And it will help get rid of weird formatting, ads, and unneeded pictures. So once you click it, it'll say it's optimizing the content. And sometimes that takes a minute. And then it will pull up a print version of the article. And you can delete items from the page by clicking them when they're highlighted green. So I kind of looked at the article before and saw where it ended, and it was right here. So all of the stuff underneath there can go. So I can go ahead and click this stuff. So I can go ahead and just delete all that. I'll delete all that. And this is really the article. And see, things like this where it says related, that's really not part of the article. So I can go ahead and delete that. Yeah. And if there is anything missing, you can click the Show More button, and it will show you all the things that it took away. See, it would have printed all of these things. So it went ahead and removed that stuff for you. So now it's only going to be 2 pages. So once you're done, you'll click Print Document. And then you just have this 2 short little pages right here to print. So you'll click print. And then there are some times that the website just will not cooperate either way. So CNN.com is one of these. So I'm on a CNN article right here. If I click here, there's no print icon. And when I click clean print, it usually, yeah, it just gives me nothing. And then even if I do the show more, I get nothing. I don't get the article. So the only option in this case is to highlight the story itself. So we're going to highlight the story and then right click and click print. And now it's only going to print the text that I selected. And it'll probably print these little pictures in there, but there's nothing we can do about that. So then you'll click print for that. It will be way better than all the stuff on the side, these ads and stuff on the side, though. So, of course, once you print something for a patron, you must put it in the receipt list. If that is not up, you can find it by clicking this printing receipt icon at the top, and then you'll put in the date and their name. And I don't remember all of them, but I know one of them was 40 pages, so that would only, or 4 pages, so it would only be 40 cents. If they give you a check, you need to put the amount in the check column, and then the check number in the check number column. Check numbers are usually at the top right. Don't mess with anything to the right here. That's just for me and the office to use. And then if anything is over $15, That has to be receipted in the receipt book by Ms. Massey, so you need to write down their student name or number or both on a sticky note, put it with the money, and then give that to Ms. Massey, and she will receipt it. If you need change for something that's going in the receipt book, just get Ms. Massey, and she'll help you get change. Don't take change out of the tray for that, because it gets turned in separately. And then if someone pays and they have change left over that they want to add to their account, you just pull them up on Atrium. So I'll come over here to Atrium, and there's the bookmark for that. I'll pull up their account. I've already done that here. And then I'll click fines, the amount beside fines owed. And then right here, I would put whatever the change was. So that was 40 cents. So I will get 60 cents back. But I just want to apply that as credit. So I'm going to check apply change to patron credit. I don't want to pay for my fine. So I'm going to uncheck that box and then click pay. And it automatically added that 60 cents. So now I have a $2.20 credit right here that can be used for my fines, for future printing, whatever. So that's on my account, ready to go. And that is how to print articles.